Alright, we're gonna be playing more Lords of the Fallen. I'm excited. Oh, I'm a little stiff and sore. I slept really hard. Right. We got that key now, so we can do a few things. Oh yeah, I left off here. I'll warp to my sibling. You can have a bell on your head. I didn't read this. To Agatha, two things matter more than anything else in life: the way, the sword, and the way of Arius. Fiercely pursuing both, the latter led to her joining a small extreme branch of Orisum, in which, in an effort to gaze upon the face of Arius, the most pious would deliberately blind themselves by staring into the sun long enough. Agatha gladly sacrificed the sight only to see nothing but darkness in return. An outcome which, while not diminishing her swordplay one bit, shattered her faith. And once the tower, Agatha discovered a new purpose, her blades flashing swiftly and deadly in the light of the lumbar amp. Lamp. Not amp. Yeah, amp it. Oh. 23 deaths. Begin with that dude scared the fuck out of me. A bunch. That's a thing. It snagged out of the... Okay. damn, damn. I'm just trying to see what's... Man, I did so good, and then... Bye-bye. Oh, my dad sent me something. My wife messaged me earlier. A TikTok they sent me. A family feud episode. Okay. Thank you. It looked like something you could push down, but I guess I was wrong. Yeah, I guess I'm sprinting through this. I'm just being dumb at this point, trying to explore. Shoved off. Oh. I shouldn't have tried recovering my vigor. I should have said fuck it. It's not like I'm trying to keep it right now anyways. Try and bum rush through it so I want to see what else is here. I didn't keep going down. I'll remember this. I keep just dying. It pissed me off. I need to just focus on going down. Thank you. bumped them with my dodge. That's fun. Fucking head dudes are annoying. That's a fake ladder. No, it's a real ladder. Go, shock, Alright, then I need to go up there. Okay. Kill himself. What is that? What is that? Oh, it's probably catalyst. Go all the way up to the vestige. Oh, it does. Fantastic. Let's rest. Interesting, that goes for the dog. Right up, so I can't wait to see what's over this way. As a blacksmith. Okay, kill the dog first.
To Gerlinda's skills, waste of her time.
Woohoo, Gerlinda. Most likely going to die here. Fuck. That's annoying. And I think opening that door is gonna draw everyone out. Thank you. find out where we go. Bitch, fall. Fall to your death.
So, you're not another of these fools. Good. That key. No one gets the better of Gerlinda for long, finally. Make a slave of Gerlinda. Ha! You don't count. Doing an old coward a kindness. Doing an...
Okay. Resistance to all suspects. That's cool. Go back up to Vest. Now I see if she gets caught to the other place. So I'm just not going. Whoop. Bring me to Skyvest. Yes.
Ah, you again. Gerlinda found herself a place to do a little business.
She hasn't but, Groak or human. Sturdy armor and lethal weapons are a universal language. Speaking of business, Gerlinde has something you might be able to help with. She's looking for some items. This whining bag of bones left in Mornstead a long time ago.
Gerlinde is undeserving of what she seeks, traveler. And self-centered besides. You would do well not to aid her in...
You know full well the agony Gerlinde can inflict on you as long as you wear those manacles, Sparky.
My name is not...
Silence! Annoying as he is, Sparky does possess certain very rare knowledge, which he refuses to share. But he carved this knowledge in crystal. And now Gerlinde wants those crystal tablets to help in her runesmithing.
Oh, nice.
So, if you find any in your travels, bring them to Gerlinde and she'll do right by you.
As I would not to Gerlinde, I will not reveal the locations of the tablets to you, traveler. Even upon pain of death.
Ah.
Oh,
you
so.
Again.
Oh, different arrow types. Cool. I want to make sure I have that. Hallowed Praise, Short Sword, C minus.
Ah, you again.
I have like 10 of these belt staffs. I only want like one of each. I know, imbuement properties.
Ah, you.
Oh, yeah, I want to upgrade. Oh, I don't have the right figure. I want to upgrade my axe, please. Thank you. 715 axe and 4 stones. Shit. I have any other key items that I'm apparently just dragging along that I'm unaware of? And stuff. Yeah, this will take 40.
Chosen
I see now.
Like you are.
I can buy as many vested sheep as I want.
Until her embrace.
Costs a lot though.
The beacons must be cleansed, and Adir's malignancy, fellow chosen of Ori.
That heretical umbral, as are you.
I'm just a merchant, okay.
While even the handling of such items is objectionable, all facets of this heterodoxy must be exposed. You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. To strive in dark, while even the handling of such items, all facets of...
They do wither damage. I should pick up those neophyte daggers.
First step, after all.
Easy way to get plucked eyeballs killed by you.
Yeah.
And down we go.
So, you're starting to see through their lies. Church, crusaders, sentinels, corrupt hypocrites.
Yeah.
Butchers and madmen, a lot of them. Adir, the one true God stands on the verge of finally returning and restoring order to this broken world. And what do? Defy him.
I take it.
Fucking
there's
heretics.
Two paths. Like in Dark Souls,
Name's
you know.
Damrose.
We can stop out the flame or continue the flame.
For you. It takes Adir's cut them down.
This is a mouse. Sinner judged. SSC. Nice. Mod. Best of insight. What's this? Ah, I see. Oh, there's a path over here. I'm not far from the best. Far from the best, so I don't really see the point in using the seed. I knew it. I knew there was another vessel just around the corner. I'm gonna go to Sky Vest so I can upgrade my weapons. There we go. Unless... I don't need rest. Look out. Emerging from the vast dry lands far to the west, the weathered, laconic stranger named Oleron rode into Mornstead one morning, never revealing the reason for his arrival. If he ever had one at all, but whatever mysteries lay in the long shadowy trail behind him, there was never any ambiguity over the wrath he brought down upon the deserving after he became a land bearer. The thundering of his weapons echoing across the kingdom, only to finally fall silent during a defiant final stand amidst the stagnant waters of a forsaken fell.
Apologies for the dour mood you found me in when last we met, but I've perked up since then. Found myself a new purpose, at least something to keep me occupied while in Mornstead. I'm going to be a traveling merchant. Please, peruse my wares. Hopefully...
Some might use the... But that sounds somewhat...
I'm just putting to use that which has been discarded. You could even say that there's... Well, perhaps just a little.
Oh, you have a lot of stuff. Oh, you have, Duralium fragments. I could stick. Lucky Paul. It's a consumable. Okay. About mace. Okay. I've had those. I think I have all of those. Damn, this place looks beautiful. Ow! Where the fuck did I fall into? I shall write down. This is a moment where I keep track of my deaths. Because this will take me a few tries. I don't know what sort of effect he was putting on me. I have a feeling it was poison. Oh, my daughter will go. Shit. almost have him. No! Okay. This guy's not as hard as I thought he would be, honestly. Humanoid enemies are 10 times harder. I mean, that goes to go with like any Soulsborne games. The only, besides Liza P, for some reason the bigger they are, the fucking harder they are, because they just beat the fuck out of you endlessly. Right, down we go. Damn, man. No phase two. Heresy purged. Oh yeah, okay. That's 4 deaths added to my bar. So that brings me to 36. Nice. Of the congregate of flesh. I have two best of seeds, but I don't want to use them yet. Why? It's probably best to jump ahead. Once, no. Poison arrow. I need my synchronogs back. If I die. And also I need to spend my ship. Talk to Molu. So I can give him the remembrance. flesh tide. Relic spear. Let's get that.
Chosen bearer of the lamp, like you, I serve.
Describe harboring fundamental misinterpretations of Aureus's divine will and works. Many of the Mornstead nobles entombed in this crypt followed their teachings, believing it was the light of Aureus, not its stonework, which maintained this great structure. And yet, despite their ignorance, Aureus has allowed the bridge to stand. Is that not a sign of his benevolence?
I guess so.
The Descryer's harboring many of the Mornstead believe, and yet, is that not a sign of it?
There is a point at which pride and purpose become self-destruction and illusion, friend. But if you insist on continuing to punish yourself, then I suggest you venture into the woods. Unnaturally frozen and home to terrors they may be, they also contain one of the beacons to which you've dedicated yourself.
I'm getting close to one of the big main bosses.
What other treasures might be found there beneath the snow and ice? Mornstead may be little but a blood-soaked ruin at this point. The truth is that the rest of the world isn't far behind on the same path, even without the help of those grotesque Rogar. Our world is more conflicted than ever, with men of all stations, nations, and creeds at odds. They need someone to unite them and lead them. Where they all tear each other apart like dogs.
A thief key? Give me a random ass key. King Ranga.
You look tired, friend.
That's heretical, as are you.
Oh, you got nothing new to say. And you don't have new inventory. I need one of the bigger ones now. Oh, I was gonna go grab those neophyte daggers.
Serve a higher purpose, Crusader.
I'm gonna rest. This game gets super wonky with being in the Umbral Realm. I'll upgrade.
Radiance, judgment.
Oh, why not?
Our Immaculate Lady will bring redemption.
You, out of all the other NPCs, you're the fucking loudest. I swear to God.
Just watch your step out there. Mornstead is a...
If in doubt, you heed the captain. He's not much as he might think of.
Where did the hound get in here? Oh, pilfered coins. Oh, there's a lot of stuff. That's probably in League of Tenacity. Is that a spell? Yes. Adds weight to me. Use a bow with a throwing hand. Ultimately, I think that'll be a better use. I should read the Forsaken Fen one. Ambitious knight from the Kingdom of Hadlin, Velad's ultimate goal is to live a grand heroic life filled with exploits which would be retold with awe in songs and tales for generations to come. And the immortality bestowed by the Umbral. God damn it. Bestowed by the Umbral Lamp, Velad saw the opportunity for an unending future of glory, but this was not to be. Any significant deed she might have performed have long been forgotten. The crushing disappointment spared her, true, but doubtless no less than the horror she felt of being consumed by her own Umbral Lamp. I already read the Olwen one. Okay. I'm gonna leave it here for now. I'll play more later today. It is, I'm gonna have to pick up my wife soon, so that'll be it for now. Thank you guys for watching, I appreciate it. Peace.